Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Dragoon. We are just about to confront Graham in the Dragon's Lair. Let's see if we can beat him. Uh-oh, that looks familiar. Power of the Dragon. Oh wow, look at that. And behind the dragon there should be a Dragoon. Remember that guy, don't we, from the beginning of the game? That's Fairbrand. This is the power he obtained. So he's gonna, to be honest, I wasn't anticipating this much talking. I thought we were just gonna fight, but we'll let him speak. So His Majesty Dole got all his power and intelligence from Emperor Diaz. I might have heard that name before, I'm not sure. Lana Rose is gonna mention Emperor Diaz died 11,000 years ago. Well, the Imperial Gloriano, of course, you remember, he was the one, I believe, that led the humans in the war. So, again, we're talking about stuff from a long time ago that shouldn't still be around. But, either way, it's gonna give us a chance. We have the courage to fight against the legendary Dragoon. Oh man, you have no idea. Alright, so it's a boss battle, and this one is a two-pronged attack. Got both the Dragon Fairbrand, who looks actually a little bit smaller than I think he should, but I've also got Graham here, who's going to be using all kinds of stuff against us. Looks like he's got a... This is actually, I believe, just the basic, like, attack all wind spell, which is weird, because that's not actually a spell, that's mostly just like an attack item, but we'll go with it. Alright, so again, we've got two targets here. Basically, if I remember correctly, we want to go after Graham first. He's got some annoying attacks. Fairbrand is pretty slow and doesn't really do a whole lot, so we will just kind of leave him be. We are, of course, going to transform into our Dragoon form. Might as well get as much damage as we can. And we could use some magic here, which, you know, we might as well. It's probably not the most effective thing, especially with Dart. But we'll use some flame shot here. It's got a single target, so we'll pick Graham for it. And again, I don't expect this. Yeah, 56. That's not terrific damage, but... He had to show it, right? Might as well do it in a boss battle. And we're actually gonna save Rose's dragon form. I think. Yeah, we're gonna save it for later when we might actually need it. So let's go ahead and just have Lavitz attack. That's about all he can do. And again, I believe Graham will not counter any of our attacks. Kind of got his own Dragoon edition there. That was totally lame damage though, so not worried about that at all. Whip smack. Now I want to see Dart's physical damage. You also notice we got plenty of turns in before Fairbrand actually did anything. That's an annoying attack because that is a stun right there. Does being attacked recover stun in this game? I can't remember. No, it does not. So she's gonna... It does. Okay. Yeah, some games it's kind of hard, like, you know, some games if you get hit, you wake up from sleep, you know, stuff like that. So actually, Rose is low on HP. I didn't figure she'd be that low, but we're going to go ahead and use her Dragoon form then for a little bit of, you know, preliminary stuff. She's got two, as you may have seen, so she'll actually be able to stay in Dragoon form for two turns, which means she'll get the benefit of the added defense. So let's go ahead and use magic. If you remember, she did learn Death Dimension, but it's only a strength 25% all and fear. I think these guys are probably immune to fear, but we're going to do this single target. We're going to do Graham. So notice the Astral Drain actually has two different effects. Both we all got healed for 31 and he took 94 damage. So that doesn't quite divide out evenly. One got lost somewhere, but we'll ignore it. And we'll go ahead and tag Grant. As you can see, he's already in the yellow, so we're actually doing, you know, quite a bit of damage to him already. And that's where Rose can really come in handy. Mostly early on, Astral Drain kind of loses its, you know, specter a little bit by the end of the game. But, you know, especially early on when you need that healing, you know, that's a heal all for 30, which isn't fantastic. But at this point in the game, it's, you know, it's okay. Got another stun, but I think she'll be all right. Yeah, you know, she also probably took way less damage than she took before. I didn't pay attention to the number last time. So she's going to get another turn. We don't really need another Astral Drain. Most of us are pretty much all right. But, you know, it actually did a lot of damage, and we can recover MP. We've got 40 of it, so, you know, why not? Let's do it again. So, unfortunately, there is no shortened magic animation options, so we'll have to sit through it, or at least I'll have to sit through it. You don't have to sit through anything you don't want to, I guess. So yeah, that's gonna finish him. He's gonna say he's got a deep gash, so it's gonna take him out of the battle. He just kinda like teleports there, which is really weird looking, but we'll go with it. Now we're just up against Fairbrand, so, you know, you've seen he doesn't really do a whole lot, so we shouldn't have too much trouble with him. We're just gonna have to pretty much slowly hack away at him. You know, maybe get some more Dragoon attacks in there. Maybe we'll show Dart's magic or something. Ooh, that's a pretty nasty poison. And we might heal that. Lavitz doesn't do too much damage. So let's actually go ahead. We've got plenty of body purifiers. Poison's just one of those real annoying things. Like, it's probably not going to kill you by itself, but I just hate that ticking damage every time. And this game is one of those games where it's 10% of your max health, so he'd be taking 21 damage each turn, which I'm not a huge fan of. Yes. Go. Actually, we already used Dart's magic, didn't we? I totally forgot. Yeah, we used it against Graham earlier, so scratch that. If he gets Dragoon form, we might just use it to get a Dragoon attack in. More poison. Well, I guess we can start using our items, huh? Also, you probably figured it out, but Fairbrand will also not counter your attacks. Alright, yeah, Dart's got a Dragoon form, so let's get an addition in. I do kind of hate that it takes like 5 or 10 seconds to get back to the menu. There we go. It's just disappointing if you don't get the last one, because he like freezes mid-animation. It's not cool. You also see that only did 78. Dart's regular edition does like 64, so it's not like we're gaining much by doing that. And we're also not gaining the little bit of SP, you know, that it would be used to level up the Dragoon level in the first place, so, you know, maybe you're better off just not using it if you don't absolutely need it. It's probably the case. Yes! And you may not have seen it, but Fairbrand is in the red now, so he's pretty close to done. Gonna get one more attack in, I believe, and Rose might finish it off. Yep, there he goes. So, again, kind of an underwhelming boss battle, really not too hard. Ooh, look at that plate mail. That must be a rare drop. I don't know that I've ever actually seen that. That's interesting. Alright, well, everyone leveled up a whole bunch and we got some cool stuff, so we'll check that out in a bit. Thank you. goes. You know, maybe Rose has a point. And I'm sure he felt some kind of guilt, you know, deep down inside about killing Servi and all that. And of course, the green Dragoon spirit. Looks like now it needs a new master. It can't be, or is this fate? Come on, Rose. You know, it's totally fate. This was destined from the start. Dart's right. The Dragoon spirit of the Drade Dragon. The Jade Dragon. There we go. Recognized you as the next master. I kind of like it. The Dragoon spirits almost have a personality to them. Like, they fall to the ground and it kind of, you know, like de-illuminates or whatever. Then when he picks it up, it warms up again, like, oh, you picked me up. Thank you. So once McGram left, he accepts it, the fate of a Dragoon. So now 3/4 of our party have their Dragoon spirits. Nice. Like Dart and Rose for justice. And of course, Rose always scoffing as she does. Dragoon spirit of the Jade Dragon. Nice. Yeah, good for you. Shauna's like, yeah, good for you guys. You're all Dragoons. Yeah, here she goes again. No, we're gonna have to go to Lohan. So yeah, we can't really make it back if Shauna's in, you know, really bad condition. There's a great doctor there. All right, well, that sounds good. Might actually need that, you know? All right, so that's it. That's our battle with Graham and Fairbrand. Let's go ahead and check out that plate mail. I imagine it's probably, like, just for Lavitz. Oh, well, Dark can get it too. Man, look at that. That's a pretty good defense increase, I gotta say. And that scale armor. So we will definitely, I think, end up giving that to Dart because these two have night shields. So, you know, might as well give him the extra defense as well. He also has an extra power. So cool, plate mail. Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen that drop. And I mean, I played this game when I was, you know, like in high school, in middle school, probably, now that I think about it. But, you know, let's just say I played it through a few times. So that's interesting. So now we get to climb this gross spider web. Not sure why there's all kinds of spider webs around. We haven't actually seen any spiders, but you know, so be it. Bucking the trend, I guess. All right, so we climb up the other side. Remember, that's where we fell down earlier. Feels like we went back a lot more than that, but I don't know. I'll take their word for it. So we've got a cross cut to Bale. Right, it's the dragon's den. So let's go ahead and head forward. Only one way to go in this little zigzag pattern, and we get the commercial town of Lohan. Let's do it. Watch out for the weird pointy elephant thing. Should you really be like shaking her like that? Are you rocking her? Like, what are you doing? So we don't get to explore the town just quite yet. We got the matter of taking Shauna straight to a doctor here. There's nothing wrong with the body, but her consciousness is closed inward. The mind is poison, not the body. Well, that's some deep stuff. Be a week if she's lucky. Man, that would suck, right? Actually, the trick is she didn't actually fight against it. It was us three. She just kind of hung out, but you know, we'll let them think that, right? Dragoni plan, huh? Again, very aptly named Dragoni. Yep, that's always the case with these things, huh? Yep. So, the good news is we're in a big town. It's got people from all over the place, so, you know, if we're gonna find information about it, this is probably our best bet, really. Rise to the occasion. There you go. That's the spirit. Alright, so now we get the chance to explore Lohan. As you can tell, Lohan... I'm gonna switch between Lohan and Lohan, by the way, so just get used to it. As you can tell, it's a pretty big town. Lots of different doors to go into, and once you see the inside of the buildings, it's gonna seem even bigger. That's the people, I love these guys here. The guy across the street makes me feel at ease. The reason I feel that way is... Well, let's see what the other guy's got to say. Yeah, girl across the street seems to be interested in me. Such a sinful guy. Some unknown lady fall in love. Well, she was gonna tell us the reason, actually. Let's go back. The guy across the street looks like the dog I used to have. Oh, man. Burn. I always thought those two were cute. Let's see. So we've got a handful of things to be doing. Obviously, Lohan's a big town. We're gonna be doing some shopping. Now we've also got a handful of starters we're gonna be picking up. It probably won't take anywhere near as long as the Bale segment did. But we might as well get to it. Let's go ahead and start. We'll just kind of hang out by the entrance here. You know, kind of tackle it from the ground up. Interesting little camera angle here. I like this a lot. Alright, so on the very first screen, we got a basal soldier here. You know, be careful when you shop. It's really a shame. Yeah, if only there was some kind of regulation on that. Check the jar here. Actually... No. Can we? We've got to be able to get it right now. I must have just went too far. There we go. What's this doing in rainwater? And we get some more stardust. So I knew it was right there. That's just like right on the edge of where you can actually go without being scolded. An unaligned town of merchants. Don't favor either one. Well, you're gonna have to. What about you? What are you doing? Oh, thank you. Well, fair enough. There's a kid up here. Let's see what the kid's doing. How can we go back? I don't know. Walk? Like, it's not that big. It's only a few screens. You'll make it. All right, before we head back upstairs, we can also make our way over this way. And this will be an area that we'll be getting back to later. Not really a whole lot for us to do right now. I think in one of these... Oh, look at the little pig things. I think maybe in one of these cages? Oh, what did that say? Chipmunks for sale. I used to have a chipmunk when you were little. That's interesting. Maybe it is elsewhere. I know there's one somewhere on this screen. Let's see. Oh, we can get the box into the box. That just totally blended in. I did not see it at all. I'm wanting to say it's in this corner somewhere. Yeah, chipmunks for sale. Up there we go. In the basket. Again, not a complete sentence, but we'll get the stardust. A little tricky to find. I didn't remember exactly off the top of my head where that one was. I think that's people around here. I never talked to these people. I don't know that I have ever talked to this person in my life. Yeah, what about you? Selling anything? Eggs! Want some eggs? Maybe if we leave them in our inventory long enough, they'll turn into a chicken. Fresh vegetables, yep. So you can't buy anything from these guys, they're just kind of here for show. And there's also a secret one. We might as well just collect the stardust while we're here. There's still one more that I'm going to wait on, because it's in kind of a plot area. So if I'm not mistaken, we need to be making our way up. Probably I could have taken a more efficient route to get here. And if we go in this door, we'll also get to see the inside of the structure, which is a little bit crazy. Yeah, look at that, man. So we can head up here, and if I'm not, I think there is... there it is. Yeah, we gotta stand in just the right spot. There's a little secret passage here by the bookcase. Well, let's get down here to this guy. That's all he says. You don't get anything for it. But once again, Dart gets rewarded for his habit of sticking his hands inside a fire, and we get some more Stardust. So unfortunately, got to go all the way back up and reopen the secret passage again. I mentioned Kazos the other day. The Pyrosone Dora has a dragon. I think we might have heard of Kazos before. That's actually the capital city of the Sandoras. So, you know how... letters down here, I couldn't find it. You know how the our country has the capital of Bale, which we've been to? Well, Sandoras have Kazos, so there you go. Alright, so it's all the Stardust we're going to get for now. Again, there's one more to get here in the city, but we will be picking up at a later date. Let's see what we got. Some items down here, which I'm really just not even interested in. Because the item situation is actually a little out of control. So we'll just check out the equipment instead. Again, it can be a little confusing, but, you know, pay attention. This is the exact same building we were in before. It's kind of weird that it shows all of them. I don't know if that's necessarily the best decision, but, you know, it's what they went with, so we'll deal with it. See, Lance we've already picked up. We can buy a cape, which is a ton of extra magic attack, so we're definitely going to do that. Not sure why a cape gives you extra magic attack, but so be it. You can also see this place has some interesting equipment we can purchase. If you happen to have 10,000 gold at this point, which I guess is not impossible, but man, look at those stat boosts. You can tell that's something we're not supposed to get till later. And of course, all kinds of accessories, including some interesting ones. It's War God Calling we could actually afford. As you can see, it says half damage and SP, so... don't use this. Even if you fail the addition, you'll probably do more than half damage. Reduce damage from all attacks by half. That's really nice. Physical damage, magic damage, and then Ultimate War God makes the addition completely successful. None of this half damage stuff. It's so, again, it's probably not worth the 10,000 gold, but I don't know. If you really have trouble with additions or something, I don't know. Alright, so now that we've shopped a bit, let's talk to a few people every now and then. Yeah, in the end it became like a maze, you're telling me. I know, I guess if you were a kid that would be a pretty good place to play hide and seek. So, the guy mentioned Davis's antique shop, so that's probably a lady. A little far away, but that's what I would guess anyway. So, got weird stuff, and remember we did meet that guy back in the volcano. It's actually just right over here, let's talk to this kid. I lost my paw. Well, hope you find him. He's such a troublemaker. So you're the responsible one of the family, huh? So yeah, we can check out this blue door back here. And what do you know? It's the exact same guy we saw before. Just some weird shoulder pat ritual. I don't know, I guess that's what they do in this country. Yep, now he can run his business. Says we can find anything, so, you know, hey, why not give it a shot? So, we're gonna ask him about the Dragoni plant. He seems to know it. No. It says he remembers hearing about it somewhere, which, well, that's better than any lead we've got. North of the Poison Forest, past the troublesome plant, observed Dragoni plant in the back of the shrine. Yeah, and also, someone finally mentions that weird dangly plant thing that we saw back there. I don't know, like, if the dragon's dead, there shouldn't be poison anymore, right? Unless it's just, like, permanently, you know, ingrained in the forest now. So, how about spring water underground? That might help. So, looks like we've got at least a little bit of a plan. Thankfully, he knew something, otherwise we would just be totally out of luck. Nope, not buying anything, that's it. But, we are actually gonna go back in, so I kinda wish they didn't force you out. I don't think you can do any actual shopping. Yo, man. Well, he's underground already? Wow, that was quick. I guess through this little ladder here. Man, in like 10 seconds, he made it all the way down there. That's pretty impressive, actually. And somehow this guy got in the store without us seeing? I don't know. There's some weird stuff going on. Climbing some ladders here. They're a little hard to see. But we basically need to be making our way to the top level. Keep getting stuck on things. This seems to happen a lot. We can actually check out this suit of armor, and we'll get our next Stardust. So should be everything here. We should be up to 14. Yep, and we are. It's also worth mentioning this is just totally open, which is weird. Like, it seems like that'd be really bad if it was raining or something. Like, maybe they got some kind of cover for it, I don't know. But you just, like, ruin everything if it was, like, storming really hard or something. Yeah, I guess it's pretty when it's nice out, but I don't know about, you know, other times. Okay, so that's basically it for us in Lohan for right now. You know, we could explore more houses and stuff, but there's not too much I'm actually worried about getting at the moment. You know, if it comes down to it, I'm sure we'll be back here, so if we really need to, we can check it out later, but I think for now we're just gonna get going. Hey, classy brother, there you go. Alright, well, let's see what they gotta say. So we do need something to carry the water. I guess we can't just cup our hands and hope we don't spill any on the way out. No, I don't know that we need a durable, best quality one. Really? Like any street vendor would actually say that? I'm pretty sure that is more money than you can ever get in the game. Like, I think it's one more digit or something like that. Maybe it's a few more digits, I don't know. Yeah, let's look somewhere else. Just kidding. Well, like, you thought we would actually pay that and just risk losing your customer? You're a terrible merchant. So it says the real price is 3,000 gold, which is ridiculous. So that's way too expensive. $2,200, that's still too much. I don't really even like four figures for a bottle, you know? Like, I can get something that auto-completes my addition for 1,000. I can do better than that. You know, even now that I think about it, if you get a health potion, what does it come in? It comes in a bottle, right? And those are 10 gold. And you're gonna have to drop it, probably more than once. 100 gold, that's still 10 times. I could just buy a health potion, drink it, and use the bottle. Oh, it's free. Okay. You are a terrible vendor. First he said it costs like 100 billion gold, and that's like, oh, well, now it's free. Just take it. So we get a water bottle. Of course, the trick there is if you just keep haggling him down, he will go all the way down to the low, low price of 0 gold. So it may be tempting to, like, when you say drop it once more, it may be tempting to buy that 100 gold, but stay firm. You can get it for less, I promise. So that's probably going to do it for right here. We're getting ready to head on into another section of the game, and I believe I'm just about ready to put it down for the day. So I'm going to head out and save, but we'll do that afterwards. So thank you guys for watching. Next time we will head out, see if we can find the Dragoni plant in order to save Shauna. So until then, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you then.